Assalamu alaikum, sir. My name is Praveen Kumar, and I am a computer programmer by profession. First of all, I would like to thank you for delivering such a wonderful lecture. And my question is, from your presentation, it's very crystal clear that whatever the righteous path set in the Islam, it's also set in the Christianity. So why not a Muslim or a Christian take up both and take the good deeds in both the things and follow it?
The brother asked a very good question and a very important question, and a chance to clarify my talk also. Asked a very good question. That if everything is good, I've talked about similarities in Islam and Christianity, everything is good, so why don't we take the good of the religion? That's what I've done. I've taken the good of Christianity, that is the Bible. I can give a talk, a longer talk, differences in Islam and Christianity, which I don't intend doing. There are many things which I don't agree with the Bible. Many things, because I don't consider the Bible as a whole to be the word of God. We believe in the Injil which was revealed to Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. But the present Bible is a corrupted form of the original revelation which was given to Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. This Bible, if we analyze, has got hundreds of contradictions, has got hundreds of mathematical errors, has got many scientific errors. I had a debate with Dr. William Campbell, Quran and the Bible in the light of science, and I pointed out many scientific errors. These scientific errors, these contradictions cannot be attributed to Almighty God. There is even pornography in this Bible, which if you ask me to read, even if you pay me $1 million, I can't read in front of the public. Pornography. Ezekiel chapter number 23, and I can quote the references, but I cannot read it. I cannot. Islam doesn't give me permission. So what I have done, brother, I have followed the guidance of the Quran of Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3, verse 64, which says, Ta'ala wila kalmitin sawa im bainana bainakum. Come to common terms as between us and you. At least what is common, we agree to follow. What is not common, we'll discuss it later on. See, when we have an interfaith dialogue, I disagree with the way interfaith dialogue takes place in different parts of the world. There is a Christian who comes and says, all religion are good, Islam is good, Christianity is good, Hinduism is good. Then a Hindu comes and says, Islam is good, Christianity is good, Hinduism is good. Then a Muslim comes and says, Islam is good, Christianity is good, Hinduism is good. Then when I ask the question, will that Christian priest give up Christianity and accept Islam if both are the same? The answer is no. Will the Hindu give up his religion and become a Christian? The answer is no. Will the Muslim give his religion and become a Hindu? The answer is no. It is nothing but hogwash. What I have done, I ask the people, at least let us agree, that one scripture in the world is 100% the word of God. No one will have problem in that. The Hindu will say, okay, I don't mind accepting my scripture, the Veda, to be the word of God. 100% correct. The Christian will say, I have got no problem. I wouldn't mind accepting Bible to be the word of God. The Muslim will say, I have got no problem. I wouldn't mind accepting Quran to be the word of God. Now, take out the common factors in all these major world religious scriptures. At least agree to follow what is common. All the major world religions, they say there's one God. They say idol worship is wrong. All the major world religious scriptures say that the last and final messenger to come is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So when we analyze, I say, let us at least agree to follow what is common. All the major religions speak about modesty, even Hinduism. And earlier when I'd come to Dubai last year, I gave a talk on similarities between Hinduism and Islam. Even Hinduism says there's one God. Idol worship is prohibited. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is going to come. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is mentioned more than 100 places in the Hindu scripture. Even Hindu scripture says that you should be modest. The woman should be completely covered. There should be covered. Polygamy is allowed in Hinduism, in Christianity, as well as in Islam, about modesty, not to have alcohol, not to gamble. That doesn't mean everything of Hinduism is correct. Similarly, everything what today the Christians follow is not correct. What I have done, I have used the Furqan. Quran is the Furqan, the criteria to judge right from wrong. What is matching with the Quran, I have got no objection in accepting that to be correct. What contradicts, I disagree. There is certain things mentioned in the Bible. The prophets did incest with the daughter. Now, how can I agree that Prophet Lut, alayhi salam, Prophet Lot, did incest with his daughter? I can't agree with that. What I say, this portion cannot be the word of God. It is adulteration. It is a corruption. It's a fabrication. Therefore, I'm saying that if you read the Bible, there's something like the red letter Bible. This is a red letter Bible. Red letter means all the words that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, spoke are in red. And if you compile them, it will hardly be two columns of the newspaper. Very little, a small percentage. What I'm trying to tell, that at least let us agree to follow what is common. That doesn't mean I agree everything of the Bible. Because the today's Bible is not maintained in the original form. Why? Because all the previous scriptures, as I mentioned in my talk, were supposed to be meant for those people and for that time. Today, you have to follow the last and final message, that is the glorious Quran, and the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Irrespective whether they're born in India or Pakistan or America or UK or UAE or Saudi Arabia, you have to follow the last and final revelation, the Quran, and the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. You tell me to take the good points, I've taken the good points of Christianity. As far as Islam is concerned, I don't know a single bad point. You point out to me and I will give you the reply. I challenge anyone to point out a single verse of the Quran which is against humanity. Don't point out the Muslims. I'm not here to support the Muslims. I'm here talking about Islam. To understand Islam, don't look at the Muslims. Look at the Quran and the authentic hadith, the sayings of the Prophet. And I challenge anyone to point out a single statement in the Quran or the hadith which is against humanity. There may be certain statements you may feel is wrong because of lack of knowledge, not having the statistics of the world. But inshallah, if you think anything is wrong, you're most welcome to point out. And I will try and explain to you why this is there in Islam, the reason and the hikmah behind it. Hope that answers the question.
Thank you, sir.